First of all of you make your video visible. If you all want to learn properly, then make your video visible. Okay, good. I can see the videos of the students now. So let's start. Today we are going to start our chapter that would be advanced features of Excel. Advanced features of Excel. I know that you all have already worked in Excel, but today we will be studying some more features for Excel. Okay, so first of all we'll be learning the components for a chart. We'll be learning to insert a chart. To insert a chart, we all have to click on the insert tab. Insert tab is there on the left side, on the upper left side. You all can see that insert tab and you all have to click on it. After that, you all have to click. You all can see that chart option is available there and you have to decide that which chart you want to make. Okay. On which tab you all have to go? You all have to go on insert tab, and after going on insert tab, you all will see that there is a chart option available and different types of charts are there. Firstly, I'll go for a simple chart, 2D chart. See, this is my chart format and I can make it anywhere where I want to. Okay. I don't want to move the chart. This is okay. I'll write the things and the chart would be drawn according to my things. Like, I want one category, that is for marks. First, let's enter the things, marks, class. Your few subjects, math. Then English, then here comes Hindi. Okay, this is you are going. I'll write here past students. Here I'll write fail students. And here I'll write absent students. In math, total out of 10 students, 8 students were passed, 1 was fail and 1 was absent. This is a record which I am entering. You all are able to see it. Raise your hands, those who are able to see it. Not in the app, just in the video only, raise your hand. Sahil, I can see your hand. Mukul, Devansh, Nakul. Vedanshi, I'm able to see. Srijan, if you're able to understand, raise your hand. Okay, Devansh, I can see it. Sahil, I can see it. Good. In English, we are having nine students were passed, 0 were fail and 1 was absent. In Hindi, 10 students were passed, 0 were fail and 0 were absent. This is all chart which I have to make. I'll make a column for 3D. See, I have entered the data and the chart is here for me. You all can see it. See, pass ratio was this and number has been given. Fail ratio, in only one there was a fail and otherwise it was zero. And in absent it was there. It is mentioned that for math blue color is there, for English red color is there, and for Hindi green color is there. So I think the chart is clear. So now we will be studying the components of chart. First, let me divide it and then one by one, I'll explain it. I'll make my window a little bit smaller. I'll move my chart here. Okay, and this is my chart. Chart components. Chart component. Chart area. Chart area is the area where that is drawn. You all know chart area. Chart area is the place where chart is drawn. Okay. And category axis and value axis. Now let's see where is category axis and where is value axis. This is your category axis. Jahan par pass, fail and absent are written na. they are called category axes, and their values are given like 12, 10. These are the values. Numbers are known as the values. So this is your value axis. So don't get confused. When you have to define the category, category is pass, fail, absent. Ki kaun bacha pass hai, kaun bacha fail hai, aur kaun bacha absent hai. That is a category. So which is the category axis? This is the category axis. And what is the value axis? Where the values are written are known as value axis. I hope this is clear to you all. Raise your hands if it is clear to you in the videos itself. Okay, let's come to the next part, that is data series. What are the data series? All the data which is written in a particular form, all the data which is written, okay, all the data which is written and the bar which is drawn is known as data series. This is the data series. The written data is known as data series. Then we come to our next